I am going to do trials 2 and 3 in the stoichiometry part A reaction. So I am going to tear my watch glass, set this to 0. Oh, what am I doing? Put it on there. And then I'm going to tear it. Oh, there we go. I'm going to let that read 0. And then I'm going to add some baking soda. Just 2.3 grams or so. Oh, that's too much. Take away a little more. 2.4. 2.3. Now in the lab, we'd love to have another decimal in there. We don't have that. So the mass of baking soda is 2.3 grams for trial 2. All right. Next up, I'm going to take, my beaker. Make sure it's dry. I'm going to re-zero that balance. So in the lab, we'd love to work with 2 decimal places. But we do not get that in this case. So I have my clean, dry beaker. I'm gonna weigh that. Oh, no, I need to add my acid. Okay. So you can see I've got 50. Oh, the camera, I moved it, so the camera's on the other side. Yeah, 50 mils. It doesn't have to be precise. We're using excess acid for this. So we wanna make sure that we react all of the sodium bicarbonate. Okay, read 0. I'm gonna weigh my beaker with the acid. So this is the mass of the beaker with the acid before. This is 159.9 grams. And then I'm gonna weigh this together. So my balance says 0. This is the watch glass with the baking soda on it, and that is 57.9 grams. Okay, now in the instructions, we'd weigh them all together, but that exceeds the capacity of the scale there. Okay, so I will go ahead and do the reaction. Make sure my little scooper is clean and dry, and I'll put a little bit of this in there. Okay, while that's reacting, I am going to weigh the watch glass after. The watch glass after is 55.7 grams, and I'll line up my next trial. This, it doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to be, oh well, it looks pretty good. 50 mils there. All right, let's give this a swirl. Oh, I see a little bunch of stuff in the bottom, so I'll stir that a little bit. Normally, we'd like to use a glass stirring rod because they're easier to clean. I don't have one, so I'm using a spatula. All right. So I will weigh that after, read 0, put it on. So the beaker with the products after reaction is 161.2 grams. So we will have two measurements to add together for the stack before and two measurements for the stack after. Now notice, do you see that there is, there's still a little bit of reaction going on. Oh, I didn't look at the... Is it still there? I see some bubbles rising. Probably those are going to be a small amount of gas. But that shows me that there is some reaction still going on. Okay, I can see there's a dog hair in there too. I guess that's a problem with working at home and not in the lab. But if we think about the effect of that dog hair on our reaction, that I'll be measuring before and after, so it'll just cancel out. Okay, oh, I did lose a little more mass. Let's cross out that last one. We'll make it 161.1 grams is the mass after. Okay, I think it's stopped. I don't see any more bubbles. Great. Okay, so I'm going to rinse this out and dry it again. And we are gonna start trial three. So let me drain that on the dish rack. Here we go. Wipe this one down too. I'm going to tear the watch glass. Now the balance reads zero. And I'm going to add. I spilled a bunch back here. It's fine. 2.2. Oh, 2.3. Alright, 2.3 grams of just the sodium bicarbonate. Alright, let me get my beaker. Get a final dry. And re-tear my balance. Add my acid. And then weigh that. So, mass of the beaker with acid before the reaction is 159.5 grams. All right, I'm gonna weigh the watch glass with the baking soda before reaction, and that is 57.9 grams. Oh good, that's the same as before, so seems consistent. You'll add those together to get the mass of the reactants, and then we're gonna do the reaction. You can see it's a little wet on the watch glass. I think that's all right because normally we'd have it like this and we'd weigh it all together. So that water will be included in the mass. it was in there to begin with. All right, while that reacts, I'll weigh this after. 55.6. Mass of the watch glass after is 55.6 grams. Let this react completely. Still a tiny bit of bubbling. It seems to mostly stopped. I'll go ahead and weigh it. Balances on to zero. And that is 160.7. 160.7 grams. So that concludes part A. The only difference from the instructions is you'll have to add the two measurements of these after reaction to get the stack together after the reaction. So hopefully we can talk about that on Monday in lab if you have any questions.